Hi, this is Rich. So you want to be free, but where do you start, right? Let me tell you a little story about freedom, okay? About, well, there's spiritual freedom, there's financial freedom, there's being free in a society, in a country, in a world, where there isn't financial slavery, where there isn't an oppressive government, things like this. But I realized today, while watching a video on how to tell a story in a video to like improve my channel, to get financial freedom, I learned some really profound things about myself. And I wanted to share that with you because I think people like you are probably into freedom like me. And what I learned was that my channel, it's like all over the place. And I've been stressing about being thematic and being kind of staying on track, but I get all over the place. But today I realized, oh, everything I share about almost, except an odd video here and there, is about freedom. I realized how much I am into freedom. This whole thing about the New World Order, shadow government, and oppressive government, and all these crazy, creepy things that are going on in the world, that's about my desire to not just be free, but to help others be free. In a world that is very oppressive, behind the scenes, this world is very dark. So, how do you get free? How do you do this? Where do you start? First of all, I think being free or getting free is a process more than it is a goal, and it's all relative. Relatively speaking, you're free, I'm free, but relatively speaking, we're not so free, right? So, this is my little story about freedom. I'm about spiritual freedom, and it started when I first got out of body when I was about 15 years old. It was just an amazing experience. You're wide awake, you're crystal clear in thinking and awareness. And I was listening to, I heard piano music, just, you know, just like somebody jamming. And apparently it was me, because I was just listening to the music and I go, well, can I play saxophone music with this? And I just imagined saxophone music playing, and it started playing. Crystal clear. And I'm not a kind of a person that recalls audio memory. I don't hear it in my head. But in this out-of-body experience, I did. So that was my first introduction to getting out-of-body. And then I started getting more and more interested in it. I read some books on it, mostly novels, fantasy novels, where guys, people would get out-of-body, and they'd wake up in another world. I just love that. To be free to do that. So then when I got in the Air Force, I went overseas, and now I'm overseas and I want to get off this island, the Philippine Islands, during the Vietnam era war thing. I was working in a bomb dump back then. And I go, man, I hate this place. I went out of here. So I really got interested in getting out of body. So when I got back to the States, I search. And I found these things that would help me. How can I get out of body? What's it take? And then I learned about the mind, because it's the mind and the subconscious mind. It's our beliefs and our mental energy and mental stuff that's keeping us from getting out of body and being free. So that launched me into, well, how do you undo the mind? Well, you do it with traumatic incident reduction. Well, that makes sense, but I don't want to learn how to give people sessions and do this past life stuff. I just want to be free. I want to get out of body and be free. But no, okay, pay for the course, buy the course, learn how to do past life regressions. And then I started learning about our past lives, galactically speaking. And this is how I find out about galactic wars and all the amazing advanced civilizations that we've come from, like millions and billions of years before we were here. And the idea that, well, let me put it this way, how long you have lived and been free, or how long you have been alive in spirit, working at being enslaved or getting involved and getting into trouble and causing yourself to be enslaved mentally, emotionally, psychologically, or in physical bodies on planet Earth, it all blends together. But you can learn more about this when you do past life regression stuff. And for those who can't do past life regression on their own, I met a little girl named Avila, who is psychic as can be, and she can see your imagery, your past, my past, entities around us in our spaces. She's an indigo child, and she's into this freedom trip too, so we kind of connected in that way. So anyway, my story is about freedom. And I realize that's what my channel is about. So if you're interested in this sort of stuff, freedom, big picture, I invite you to subscribe to my channel because, you know, I've got about 1,000 videos uploaded. And all most of it has something to do with this in one way or another, breaking free. And most recently, I'm into financial freedom. And this led me to more ways of making a living doing what I love to do. And what I love to do is to make videos. And I like talking to people. So as I'm learning how to, you know, improve my channel and improve my ability to communicate and entertain you, educate you, share with you, invite you into my world, I learned some things today that were really profound. And it's like, where to start if you want to be free? For me, I'm starting, well, it's kind of a season or a mood. It's where am I at today? I'm in my financial freedom thing. Sometimes I'm into my spiritual freedom stuff and I'm getting sessions, or I'm into helping entire planet, everybody be free. So I'm studying New World Order, shadow government, Khazarian Mafia, the dark stuff, the 13 families, Illuminati, the Freemasons, all that stuff. But it's always about freedom. I didn't know that. I thought I was into truth and about truth, and I am. But it's about freedom. Just to be able to speak freely. Wouldn't that be great? George Orwell, 1984. You got to read it. Avila's reading it now. She's got it over there on her desk somewhere. She's reading it every day. Man, how telling is that? But anyway, back to the financial freedom. I'm watching this video today, and he's the teacher, the guy is saying, you want to tell a story. And you got three stories. And I go, three stories? I'm not even telling one story in a video. Maybe accidentally without really thinking about it, but they're supposed to be like, to do it well, just three stories in your video, just your like 5-10 minute video. Yeah. One is your overall theme. What's your channel about? I go, is my channel about something? This is before I had the big realization, right? Yeah. And then the second story you're telling is what season you're in, so to speak, in your life or your day or your month. It's like, that'd be like, what's my mood today kind of thing? Oh, okay. But that's got to be a subset of your overall theme, your YouTube channel theme, if you want to make money and be financially free, or whatever your thing is. I go, really? So I just want to learn how to tell a good story in a video. I want to look at different videos and tech how do you tell a good story? And there's three stories. And the last, the third story is more specifically right now, right here today. What are you doing that alludes to your second story, financial freedom, which is thematic to your overall overarching story? And I go, well, I like to give sessions and get sessions. Freedom, that's spiritual freedom. Freedom, I like to do this quiet mind stuff and practice that. What's that about? It's being free of the mind, the subconscious mind, or the limiting beliefs that, I go, well, what's this about, you know, wanting to rat out the New World Order, the shadow government, and the fake, this fake pandemic, coronavirus, fake news thing? They're pushing so hard to make that sound like a bad thing and getting people to believe in that. Well, they're trying to enslave us with propaganda. Nothing new there if you studied propaganda, MK Ultra, CIA stuff, Mockingbird Press. You know, yeah, they're working hard. The power elite are working hard to enslave us. I go, oh, I get it. This is about freedom. I just want to be free. I want you to be free. But how do you do that? Well, you find a starting place. You realize what you're about. You write your own story. I don't know. Where to start? I started with the out-of-body, the get-out-of-body thing. Because getting out-of-body, I experienced it. And when I experienced it, it was like, wow, this is good. This is really good. And it's an awakening. It's a consciousness freedom thing. You're literally free of your subconscious mind. You're free of the limiting beliefs that you have being in a body, trying to live and survive in a world like this. When you're free of the physical body, it's like subroutines or your apps are unneeded. How to survive, how to make a living, how to eat, stay warm, don't get too hot, don't get too cold. I need transportation to get here. No, you just fly or teleport. All that case, that mental programming is parked into the unmanifested aspect of your consciousness. No, I'm not needed. You just don't need it. So it's not there. It's not created. It's not affecting you. Because you're out of body. Your consciousness is shifted into other belief system territories, other realms, dimensions, planes, densities. And those places are like really real. I mean, touchy-feely. You can touch them and feel them and walk around. They're like way better than virtual reality stuff. You're really there. So I got into that just by accidentally having a few out of my experiences. And then I wanted to learn how to do it myself. So then I learned. And then I built a course to teach other people how to do it. And then to release from limiting beliefs, I built another course, Universal Release Method. And then there was this old contract. So I go, well, how does that fit in? Oh, well, yeah, once again, you're being free of agreements you've made in the past. You ever make a deal with the devil? You ever agree that you're fucked? Oh, I'm not supposed to use that word. I'm working hard to like keep it clean here. Just to get a larger viewership. But you like using the F word. Anyway, freedom. Where to start? I started with the out-of-body experience, the consciousness shift, which led me to the, learning how to keep the mind, the subconscious mind, the triggers from happening. So I started with past life regression stuff, but then it went into quiet mind practice. So that's a pretty cheap, free, easy way to get started with being free. You let that stuff go, you break free of all that. So anyway, I just wanted to share with you a quick story about myself, my channel, what I'm about, what my videos are always about, almost always. So if you're interested in this sort of thing, whether it's spiritual freedom or being free of enslavement on this in the physical world by those who are in power, stay tuned. Almost always going to be something about that. So thank you for watching. And I look forward to making more videos in the subject of freedom, financial freedom, more videos on how to make more money or create better YouTube videos, things like this, as I learn. Okay? All right. Thank you for watching. Talk to you later.